We've all had moments where we felt desperate to eat anything, but what if your only option was human flesh? Most of us have heard of cannibalism, but what happens when you eat humans? If we first look at insects, snails, fish, or amphibians, we can see that cannibalism is abundant. For example, crab spider mothers lay unfertilized nurse eggs for her spiderlings to feast on, and once the eggs are consumed, she offers herself to be eaten entirely in the process called matrophagy. But when it comes to mammals, cannibalism is more rare, often triggered by environmental stressors, like when rabbits eat their young under stressful situations. French paleontologists found human examples from 100,000-year-old Neanderthal bones, which showed signs of breaking as a way to extract marrow and eat brains, and tool cut marks suggesting that the tongue and thigh were eaten as well. But even in the 20th century, medicinal cannibalism was used in Europe, where human blood was prescribed as a remedy. Which brings us to the first issue. Without proper care and preparation, you run the risk of contracting any bloodborne disease like hepatitis or EBOLA that your victim may be carrying, as well as the risk of infection from the deceased's E. coli and other gut bacteria. Speaking of blood, we're definitely red meat. This is due to myoglobin, an iron and oxygen binding protein found in muscle tissue. Your nutritional value? Well, your thigh is around 10,000 calories, your heart 700, and your entire body? Around 81,000 calories. But about half of these calories come from adipose or fat tissue, so you aren't the best meat for those on a diet. And even though anecdotal accounts say we taste somewhere between pork and veal, and a cute culinary robot identified us as bacon, there's still an even greater risk in something called prions. Though not fully understood, prions are versions of a normal protein that has had its shape altered and not only loses its function, but becomes infectious. These distorted proteins can influence other similar healthy proteins and change them as well, causing a chain reaction and creating disease. In particular, prion disease creates holes in the brain, giving it a spongiform appearance and ultimately causing death. But unlike viruses, bacteria, fungi, or parasitic infections which contain DNA or RNA, prions don't, meaning they can't be killed with radiation or heat. These incredibly infectious prions could be present in any nervous tissue, including organs and muscles, but are most common in the brain and spinal nerve tissues, meaning if you happen to consume meat with prions in it, your risk of infection is high. Eat the brain, and that risk goes much higher. In the 1950s, researchers discovered that several members of the Foray people, a tribal group in Papua New Guinea, were suffering from a disease called kuru, or laughing disease, which caused those infected to lose control of their emotions, then bodily functions, eventually succumbing to death. It turns out that kuru was a prion disease which was contracted through their funeral practices. The Foray people believed it was better for the body to be eaten by the people who loved them than by worms and insects. And though the practice is believed to have stopped, the incubation of prion disease can take up to 50 years, meaning new cases could still reveal themselves. So while eating human flesh isn't necessarily always bad for you, especially if it lacks prions, doing so carries incredibly high risks that probably aren't worth it. Just stick with the steak. Unless, of course, you're not human, in which case there are a ton of shocking animals that practice cannibalism. Check out our video on the 10 weirdest cannibalistic creatures in nature here, and subscribe for more weekly science videos every Thursday.